appreciating him and celebrating the faithfulness of our God. Thank him from the depth of your heart as you give him praise this morning. Celebrate him, our God is faithful. Thank him and thank him and thank him and thank him and thank him this morning. Thank him and thank him and thank him and thank him this morning. He's worthy to be praised and worthy to be glorified. Blessed is the one that he chooses and causes to approach unto him, that he may fill him with the goodness of his house. Our Father, this morning we have come today to give you thanks, to give you praise, to give you glory, to give you honor and all adoration. We celebrate your faithfulness. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be glorified. Lord, we give you glory. Lord, we give you glory. Lord, we give you glory. We celebrate your faithfulness. Thank you and thank you, Lord. Thank you and thank you, Lord. Blessed be your holy name. Now begin to ask him to speak to you this morning by his word. Lord, we ask, O Lord, that your word will come forth with power. Let it come forth with authority. Let it address every department of our lives. Let it bring about the delivery of our testimonies. Let it break the bondages of the wicked. Let it bring liberty to the captive. Let it bring salvation to the ones that are not saved. We thank you for it, Jesus. We glorify you, Lord. We know that it is done. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Our Father, this morning, we have come before you with gratitude in our heart for your faithfulness towards us. Thank you for the blessing and the privilege of being in your presence. We give you the praise and all the glory. And now we are before you this morning. We are asking that you speak to us by your word. Let everyone experience a change of level in the name of the Lord Jesus. You have called it a miracle job banquet. Jesus, visit everyone accordingly in the name of Jesus Christ. We give you praise and thanks. We know it is done already in Jesus' precious name. Give Jesus a big hand, everybody. And please, you may be seated in his presence. My case is different because I'm redeemed of the Lord as a covenant child. What affects others is not permitted to affect me. Congratulations. Shiloh 2017, a new dawn. Shiloh 2017, a new dawn. We can say it personalizing it this morning. Shiloh 2017, my new dawn. And my new dawn. Remember, we are only 6 weeks away. Hallelujah. Therefore, let every one of us continue to prepare ourselves in earnest, as was announced, praying intensely as we prepare ourselves for the encounter that God has for us at Shiloh. This year, the God of Shiloh will appear to you personally. And it will turn your story around in Jesus' precious name. We have been looking at this series of teachings since the month began in our Sunday services, empowered by the Spirit to fulfill my glorious destiny. And this is the fourth part in this series of teachings. And we've been examining this fact that there are diversities of gifts, but it's the same Spirit. And we find that in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 4 to 8. There are differences in administration, but the same Lord. There are diversities of operation, but the same God is the one that works all in all. And we are told that the manifestation of the Spirit is given to everyone to profit without. So there is a profiting packaged for the manifestation of the Spirit that we experience. Shout hallelujah. And that is why we have been trying to examine the various manifestations, operations, and administrations of the Holy Ghost available to you and I in order to maximize our destinies, to see the realization of our glorious destiny. And I see for each one of us in this season, your destiny shall be gloriously maximized. Somebody believe it, say it loud, amen. So this morning we are going to continue in examining some of these operations of the Holy Ghost that help you and I to make the most of our glorious destiny in Christ. Number one, we are going to look this morning at the fact that the Holy Spirit is the spirit of wisdom. So it means the spirit of wisdom. Come on, say louder, it's the spirit of wisdom. The Holy Spirit is the spirit of wisdom. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 11, verse 1 and verse 2, it says there, the spirit of the Lord shall come upon him, and he will be the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. So the scripture here identifies the spirit of wisdom. In Deuteronomy chapter 34, verse 9, the Bible says, and the man Joshua was full of the spirit of wisdom. So there is what the Bible recognizes as the spirit of wisdom. In Ephesians 1 and verse 17, it said that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ may give unto you the spirit of wisdom. So clearly we see, because out of the mouth of two or three witnesses, every word is established. And we see clearly from scriptures that there is what the scriptures identify clearly as the spirit of wisdom. Now, really, scripturally, what is wisdom? In Matthew chapter 7, verse 24, the Bible tells us, he said, he that heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man that built his house upon a rock. I will liken him unto a wise man. So wisdom can be said to be the revelation and application of the truth. The revelation and the application of the truth. It has been said by God's servant that wisdom can be described as knowing what to do and doing it. The unveiling of what to do, the revelation, and the application of the truth is what we refer to as wisdom. And therefore it means that the spirit of wisdom has the function of unveiling the truth unto us and engaging the truth through us. That is why you see the scripture say in the book of Ephesians 1, 17 and 18, it said there that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ will grant unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened. So the spirit of wisdom opens our eyes to the realities of the truth and also engages the truth through us. The Bible says in Philippians 2 and verse 13, it is God that worketh in us both to will and to do of his good pleasure. So the spirit of God, in the function of the spirit of wisdom, opens our eyes to know what to do and helps us to do what we know to do. That is the spirit of wisdom at work in the life of a man. And when that begins to take place in the life of any individual, the result of it is the command of exploits. The command of exploit. For those who do know their God, they have a revelation of God. They understand what God wants them to do, and they shall be strong and they will do exploits. So every doing of the truth results in exploits. Every doing of the truth results in exploits. That is why the Bible said, they said concerning Jesus, whence has this man this wisdom and these mighty works? Matthew 13 and verse 54. So we discover that where wisdom is, you find mighty works present. I pray for each one of us this morning that the spirit of wisdom, which is the secret to mighty works, comes afresh upon each one in the name of Jesus. Somebody believe it, say louder, amen. I said, somebody believe it, say louder, amen. The spirit of wisdom, which is the secret behind mighty works, shall be coming afresh upon each one of us in the name of Jesus. That is wisdom at work. So the wisdom of God provokes mighty works by the application of the truth. It provokes mighty works by the application of the truth. The Bible says in the book of Mark chapter 6 and verse 6 concerning Jesus, he said they looked at Jesus and they were offended at him. Why? He said, is this not this man that we know? Where is it that is able to now do all of these mighty works? From today, people will not be able to reconcile your background with your doings. They will not be able to reconcile your education with your doings. they will not be able to reconcile your association with your doings. Because the wisdom of God shall be coming afresh upon you. They say, is this not the carpenter's son? How come he's a sign commander? How come he's a provoker of wonders? How come he's producing all of these mighty proofs everywhere? That shall become somebody's testimony here. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Somebody believe it, say loud amen. So when we talk about the wisdom that comes from above, which is the wisdom that is operated by the spirit of wisdom, we are not talking about mighty words, calculated statements. We are not talking about impressive oration. We are talking about the wisdom that provokes mighty works, divine proofs, things that are on ground and put men in awe. I see that becoming somebody's experience here. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I said, I see that becoming somebody's experience here. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You will discover concerning Solomon in 1 Kings chapter 3. The Bible tells us there, Solomon asked of the Lord, Lord, give me an understanding and a wise heart. And God said, I've given you wisdom. And it's above all of the anyone that is upon the face of the earth. And in chapter 4, the Bible tells us from verse 29 down to verse 34. It says concerning Solomon, that God gave him wisdom and largeness of heart like the sand that is at the seashore. And as a result of it, he became wiser than all men. But the wisdom was not just in his head. The Bible says in 1 Kings chapter 10, by the time the queen of Sheba came and she saw the wisdom was visible in proofs around his life. She said there was no more spirit left in her. She fainted at the sight of the manifestation of wisdom. That is, it was visible, it was clear, it could be seen. You see, on the earth, people may celebrate intelligence without proofs. That is, somebody has brain, but no breakthrough. But when you are talking about the wisdom of God, you are talking about supernatural intelligence with unquestionable proofs. On every side, you see there. When Solomon spoke, they said, this is wisdom speaking. But when Solomon acted, they said, that is wisdom going. It was clear by the manifestations of his life that the wisdom of God was at work in him. I pray for you again this morning that by the manifestation of the spirit of wisdom upon your life and my life, it will be clear that wisdom is at work in us. Somebody believe it, say louder, amen. I said, somebody believe it, say louder, amen. We come across the man Joseph. In Genesis chapter 41, the Bible tells us, after I interpreted the dream of Pharaoh and gave him the solution to the dream, the Bible says in the book of Genesis chapter 41, beginning from verse 36 all the way down to verse 41, he said, and then Pharaoh said before his servant, where can we find a man like this, in whom the wisdom of God is, in whom the spirit of God is? He said, let him be over my entire house. Because God has given you this dimension of discretion and wisdom. He said, no one will be above you except me, and only by the throne. It means that I've given you all authority. Why? It was clear that the wisdom of God was at work in him. The solution was clear. He was a solution bearer. By reason of God's wisdom, by reason of the wisdom of God that is coming afresh upon you by the spirit of wisdom today, I see you becoming a solution bearer. Yeah. And you see, when you carry answers, you are simply sought after. You don't look for things. Things begin looking for you. By the wisdom of God from this season, you will never struggle again. Yeah. I said you will never struggle again. Look at the testimony of this commission. On every side, the educational arm. Yesterday being the 21st of October, was the 15th year of Covenant University. 15th year. And look at what God has done. Within the space of 15 years, the university now classified as one of the elite universities in the world. Within the space of 15 years, in 19 areas of competency, like we heard last week, Sunday, Covenant University coming number one. In 17 other areas, coming number two in the world globally. Within 15 years, competing with 1,000-year-old universities by the power of the spirit of wisdom. You see, when wisdom comes, speed comes. You start accomplishing things in record time. I pray for each one of us again this morning that the spirit of wisdom will come afresh upon each one. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the spirit of wisdom will come afresh upon each one. In the name of the Lord Jesus. That's the power of wisdom. People come into Canaan land today and begin to wonder, is this a town that has been existing for years? Not knowing that in 1998, everything here were trees, forests, snakes, animals, birds. Only things existing here, not buildings. No roads, no sewages, no gutters, nothing anywhere. But between 1999 and now, look how a city can come from a forest. By the power of wisdom. The power of wisdom. You see, when wisdom is at work, it can turn a wilderness into a wonder. He said, and until the spirit is poured upon us from on high, he said, and the wilderness shall be turned into a fruitful field, and a fruitful field shall be counted for a forest. It is the power of the spirit of wisdom. You go to a nation like Israel today, a nation that was blessed by the wisdom of God, and you see how a nation that is located in the desert becomes an exporter of food, because the wisdom of God can recultivate your environment and turn it into a miracle to behold. I'd like you to understand something. When wisdom is at work, there is no disadvantage. What people look as a disadvantage is simply a stage to give you an advantage. For somebody here this morning, by the spirit of wisdom at work upon your life from today, I see you creating advantages out of every desert. Somebody believe it, say louder, amen. Somebody believe it, say louder, amen. So the Holy Spirit is the spirit of wisdom, and by his operation in that dimension, he empowers us to create solutions. He makes us wonders to our world. I see that becoming somebody's experience. Number two, the Holy Spirit empowers our dedication to God. He empowers our dedication to God. Look at what the scripture says in the book of John, chapter 10, verse 17 and verse 18. It says to us there, therefore my Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again. But make no mistake, no man can take it from me, but I lay it down of myself. Why? I have power to lay down, and I have power to take it again. I have power. It takes empowerment to lay down your life in dedication. It takes empowerment to lay down your life in dedication. Remember, the Bible says in the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 13, and we see here the operation of the Holy Ghost. For if you live after the flesh, you shall die. But if you through the Spirit do mortify, do kill, do deaden, do sacrifice the deeds of the body, you shall live. So it takes the operation of the Holy Ghost to mortify your flesh. The enemy of our dedication is our flesh. And it is the Holy Ghost that empowers you beyond your natural willpower to pursue after the will of God. Remember what the Bible said concerning the Macedonian church? It said, to their power I bear witness. And beyond their power, they were willing of themselves. That is the Holy Ghost operating the life of a person. It gives you power beyond your power. It gives you capacity beyond your ability. That is the operation of the Holy Ghost. And he dwells within each one of us to release these potentials. Remember, the scripture makes it clear in Ephesians 3:20, now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all we can ask or think, according to the power that is at work within you. So there is a power inside of us via the Holy Ghost that, when it's quickened and begins to operate in us, gives us capacity to live a dedicated life. And like God's servant, our Father said, you cannot be truly dedicated and not be openly decorated. The outcome of dedication is decoration. You remember the experience of Mordecai in the book of Esther chapter 6. Mordecai was to be honored, and the king asked Haman, what should be done for the man that the king desires to honor? And then Haman, thinking he was talking about him, began to describe what honor looks like. Let him be clothed with the king's apparel. Let him ride upon the king's chariot. Let the crown be put upon his head. Let the ring of the king be put in his hand. And let one of the highest princes go before him, saying, this is the man that the king desires to honor. What we saw there was the description of what honor looks like. Honor means decoration, exchange of garment. You are going from natural raiment to royal apparel. He said, exchange of crown. You are going from a crownless head to a crowned head. You are going from walking on foot to riding on king's chariots. You are going from silent movement to announced entry. That is what we talk about when we talk about honor. Honor means decoration. Decoration. And remember, it is the dedicated that are decorated. It says in John chapter 12, verse 23 down to verse 26, he said, the hour for the Son of Man to be glorified has come. But except a corn of wheat fall to the ground and die, he abides alone. But if he dies, he will bring forth much fruit. He said, he that loves his life will lose it, and he that hates his life shall save it. He said, and if any man serve me in this manner of dedication, him will my Father honor. The honor of God follows the dedication of man. And the honor of God equals the decoration of man. The Bible says in John chapter 5 verse 44, he said, ye are they which seek honor one from another, and seek not the honor that cometh from God only. There is a honor that comes from God only. And when it comes, there's no man that can dishonor you. I pray for each one of us again today that the Spirit of God that enables dedication will come afresh upon our lives. Amen. Somebody believe it, say loud, amen. Amen. I said the Spirit of God that enables dedication will come afresh upon our lives. Amen. The Spirit of God that enables dedication will come afresh upon our lives. Amen. Somebody believe it, say the loudest, amen. Amen. That's the operation of the Holy Ghost. So he's there to empower our dedication. You found him operating in a man like Paul the Apostle. And Paul began to say, woe is unto me if I preach not the gospel. 1 Corinthians 9:16. He said, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain. He said, I die daily. This was a man of full-scale dedication to God. And look at how God honored him. Till tomorrow, so Paul remains a name of honor upon the earth. Why? A dedicated life will always end up a decorated life. For somebody here, I see the decoration of God coming afresh upon your life. Amen. Somebody believe it, say loud, amen. Amen. I said, somebody believe it, say loud, amen. Amen. Somebody believe it, say loud, amen. Amen. And here it is, there's no way that a person is decorated and is not noticed. Every genuine decoration is openly noticed. Everyone sees it. There is always an announced entrance for anyone honored by God. Today, I see that becoming your own experience. Amen. Number three thing we discover is that the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of glory. It's the Spirit of glory. 1 Peter chapter 4 and verse 14. This is what it says. If you be reproached for the name of Christ, happy are ye. For the Spirit of glory and of God rested upon thee. On their part, you are evil spoken of. He said, but on your part is glorified. The Spirit of glory rested upon thee. Rested upon thee. You see, we discover that there is what the scripture referred to there as the Spirit of glory. The Spirit of glory. Never mind your mockers. You see, there is one answer that will silence mockers, and it is glory. When the glory of God manifests upon the life of a man, mockery is simply silenced. When the glory of God came upon the life of Job, the Bible said that the nobles saw him and their tongue was cleaving to the roof of their mouth. People were in shock and in awe. because the glory of God had descended upon him. I pray for each one of us this morning that the spirit of glory will come afresh upon our lives in the name of Jesus. When you have that spirit of glory upon you, you are not concerned about the mockery of men because you can behold the glory ahead. The glory is too vivid to observe the mockery. It's too clear to observe the mockery. And as the glory begins to manifest openly, suddenly the mockery is supernaturally silenced. When the spirit of glory came upon the life of the man called Jacob, the man who was totally ignored in the past, suddenly he became the man of honor. The question I ask myself is, what did Potiphar think by the time Joseph was sitting on the throne? Because suddenly here are you, subject to the one you sentenced. You sentenced him to prison, now he's your boss. That is the power of the spirit of glory. He was subject to mockery in the house of Potiphar, but he was taken to glory by the power of God. For somebody here this morning, whatever looked like mockery for you shall be converted to glory. Somebody believe it, say a loud amen. Whatever looked like mockery to you shall be converted to glory. And this spirit of glory is also known as the spirit of restoration. It's the spirit of restoration. It says in the book of Joel chapter 2 verse 23 to 27. It says, be glad, you children of Zion, and rejoice. For he had given you the former rain moderately. He will cause to come down for you the rain, the former rain and the latter rain in the same month. He said, and the floor shall be full of wheat, and the fat will overflow with wine and with oil. He said, and I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the cankerworm, the caterpillar, the palmerworm, the great army that invaded your life on every side. He said, and you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord that has dealt wondrously with you. And my people shall never be ashamed. Look at what it says in verse 27. As a result, and you shall know that I am the Lord in the midst of Israel, and that I am the Lord your God and none else. And one more time, and my people shall never be ashamed. Remember, glory refers to the eradication of reproach, removal of reproach. And here is what God said to the children of Israel. He said, this day I have rolled away the reproach of Egypt. I have rolled it away. Joshua chapter 5 and verse 9. I've rolled away the reproach of Egypt. You were covered with a reproach, but this day I have rolled it away. By the operation of the spirit of glory, whatever represents a reproach in any department of your life, today, the 22nd of October, that reproach is rolled away. That reproach is rolled away. The reproach of joblessness is rolled away. The reproach of stagnation is rolled away. The reproach of frustration is rolled away. Of backwardness is rolled away in the name of Jesus. Somebody believe it, say loud amen. The spirit of glory, the spirit of glory. In Isaiah chapter 61 verse 1, the spirit of the Lord is upon me. What is the effect? Verse 7, it said there that as a result of it, for your shame you shall have double. For confusion, they shall rejoice in their portion. Therefore, in their land, they shall possess the double, and everlasting joy shall be unto them. For your shame, for your shame. They may have mocked you, but double is coming to you. They may have castigated you, but double is coming to you. They may have been asking you, where is your God? But double is coming to you. Somebody believe it, say the loudest, amen. The spirit of glory, the spirit of glory, the spirit of glory. It rolls away every reproach. Now hear this. By reason of the spirit of glory, any name you have been called that is not of God, every name that you have they may have used as a description for you. Look at him, he's a frustrated man. Look at him, he cannot move forward. Look at him, he cannot get married. Look at her, she cannot have children. Look at her, she cannot progress. She has been on the same job 7 years, no promotion. Any negative name that you may have been called, by the spirit of glory, it is reversed. Somebody believe it, say loud, amen. I said, somebody believe it, say loud, amen. By the spirit of glory, that name is overturned. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now hear what the Bible says, Isaiah chapter 62, beginning from verse 1. For Zion's sake, I will not hold my peace. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not rest. Until the righteousness go forth like the brightness, and the salvation thereof like the lamb that burneth. The Gentiles shall see thy righteousness, and all the kings will see thy glory. And thou shalt be called by a new name, the name which the mouth of the Lord shall name. And thou shalt be a crown of glory in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of thy God. Look at verse 4. And then thou shalt no more be termed forsaken. Neither shall thy land be termed desolate. But thou shalt be called Hephzibah, and thy land Beulah. For the Lord delighted in thee, and thy land shall be married. I see that becoming somebody's experience this morning. If you are the one, say louder, amen. Did you hear what he said there? He didn't say men will see your glory. He said the kings shall see thy glory. Isaiah chapter 60 verse 1 to 3. Arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. Darkness will cover the earth, and gross darkness the people, but the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory will be seen on you. What's the effect? He said, and the Gentiles will come to thy light. And who else? And the kings to the brightness of thy rising. Look at verse 4. As a result of that glory, what will happen in verse 4? It said, and lift up your eyes and look round about. All of them are gathering themselves together. They are coming unto you. They are coming unto you. You are not going unto them. They are coming unto you. Everything you have been looking for will start coming unto you today. I said it will start coming unto you today. It will start coming unto you today. Somebody's story is changing this morning. I said somebody's story is changing this morning. You have been looking for jobs. Now job will start looking for you. You have been looking for contracts. Now contracts will start looking for you. You have been looking for promotion. Now promotion starts looking for you. Somebody say, Lord, I desire the spirit of glory. Lord, I desire the spirit of glory. I see that spirit coming afresh upon you. Why not put your hand upon your chest right now and begin to pray? Lord, the spirit of glory, come afresh upon my life this morning. Come afresh. Take your seat. Begin to pray. Be seated and begin to pray. Let that spirit of glory come afresh upon my life this morning. That will take away reproach. That will roll away reproach. That will bring me to a new beginning. Oh, spirit of glory, come afresh. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That spirit is coming afresh upon you today in the name of Jesus. I'd like you to mark it, because he said this day the reproach is rolled. Not these days, but this day. This day. Joshua 5:9. This day. This day. Not these days. Not this month, but this day. not in these few days, but in this very day, the 22nd of October, 2017. The reproach is rolled away in the name of Jesus. Somebody believe it, say loud, amen. Now, today is a miracle job banquet, and we must understand what it covers. It covers all of those in line for paid employment, that you are looking for a job. You don't have paid employment, and you are looking for one. Those that are seeking for job opportunities in their field. You have a field of study, a field of specialization, and maybe you are doing something, but it's not in your field. Contractors and suppliers without jobs on hand. Consultants without clients. Market men and women that are not making sales. Tradesmen, such as motor mechanics, carpenters, tailors, without jobs on hand. You have a skill to trade, but yet no one is trading with you. Entrepreneurs, small-scale manufacturers who are challenging their endeavors. And everyone that is not engaging productively daily requires an open door. You may be somewhere, but nothing is finding you. You are not able to express yourself. Nothing is being pulled out of you to maximize destiny. You are existing, you are not living. But today something is changing. Because a great and effectual door shall be opened unto you. Let's start by understanding that God is committed to providing for his own household. He's committed to providing for his own household. Remember, he says in 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 8, he said, anyone that will not provide for his own, he said he has denied the faith and is worse than an infidel. Anyone that will not provide. So we discover if God has this position, then that must be God's disposition himself. That he provides for his own household. And the way he provides for his own household is by the works of their hands. For anyone that will not work, let him not eat. 1 Thessalonians chapter 3 and verse 10. So it means therefore that God's way of provision is providing for us a platform to engage. A platform to engage. The scripture says in Matthew chapter 20 verse 7, Jesus speaking, he said to those that he found in the marketplace, he said, why is it that you stand all the day idle? Why is it that you so God has an expectation for us to be profitably engaged. And that means that God has provided some kind of work for us. It doesn't matter whether they say there are no jobs. There is job for you. You see, you have to know how to differentiate yourself from generalities. There are no jobs. They have cut so number of jobs. They may be cutting jobs of others, but there is a job for you. Is somebody getting what I'm saying? There is a job for you. There is a seat for you to occupy, and you will occupy it. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I ask myself, what happened to the officials who were in the land of Egypt when Joseph emerged? They must have had a food minister. Where was he? A finance minister. Where was he? They must have had somebody who was assisting the king. Where was he? When God has a job for you, it doesn't matter who is there before. Is somebody getting what I'm saying? It doesn't matter who. So don't be bothered about it. Say, oh, there are no jobs. There are no jobs for others, but there is a job for you. God has provided something for you. It is part of his responsibility as a father. The Bible says in Psalm chapter 34 and verse 10, Psalm 34 and verse 10, he said, the young lions may suffer lack and hunger, but they that seek the Lord, they will not want any good thing. Yes, they are lions. They seem to be in authority on the earth. But he said, those who seek the Lord, they will not want any good thing. So God has made provision for you. Say with me, God has made provision for me. Louder, God has made provision for me. One more time, God has made provision for me. There is something for you. Genesis chapter 21, verse 19, we had Hagar. Her son was dying and dying of thirst. And here she was, weeping in a corner, mourning the end of her son. And the Bible said God opened her eyes. Right where death was about to swallow the son by thirst, there was a well waiting. You see, I pray that for each one of us this morning, God will open our eyes. Whatever well God has provided for you, may your eyes see it this morning. I said, may your eyes see it this morning. May your eyes see it this morning. In 2 Kings chapter 4, a widow had her two sons who, before the father left, had left a debt upon them, and those sons were collateral. They were to be taken as slaves. The man, a prophet, and then here comes the widow running to Elisha. He said, Elisha, you know your servant. He was a faithful man. Now, there is this siege upon us. The son's about to be taken. And Elisha asked the woman a question. What do you have in your house? What do you have in your house? And here is the answer of the woman. And she said, thy handmaid had not anything in the house save a pot of oil. I have nothing except a pot of oil. And God said, that is enough. Get vessels, not few, and begin to pour the oil. And as she kept pouring the oil kept pouring, never concluding until all the vessels were filled. The pot was in the house, the oil was in the house, and the problem was also in the house. Many times the answer is not far from you. That is, there is a pot of oil in the house and it is cohabiting with the problem in the house. Why? The eyes have not seen it. We heard the testimony of one young man, Landmark University student. The father passed on and everything looked upside down. He thought the world has come to an end, but he made a decision. I would draw closer to God. And while at home, others are in school, God gave him inspiration. Why not begin to do fishery? And he started. Before he knew it, making sales all over Lagos, all over Ogun State, going into Benin Republic. By the time school would start, he had 70% of his fee out of his business into school. Paid the school fees, went through school, through the business God put in his hand. The land to do it must have been right around him. But the eyes to see it was what God needed to give him. I pray for somebody here today that the eyes to see will be granted to you today. I said the eyes to see will be granted to you today. There are some under the sound of my voice, you are looking for a job, but you'll be an employer of labor. I said you will be an employer of labor. In the name of Jesus. The scripture says in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 5 and verse 9, it said the profit of the earth is for all. Even the king is served by the field. The profit of the earth. So there is profit for all on the earth. And I pray that for you, you will secure your own. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I said you will secure your own. That is why you must keep asking God, Lord, give me the eyes to see. The opportunity may not look like anything that is colorful, but simply engage it. God's servant and father was telling us the testimony of one student at Covenant University who had deferred her, school time and went to begin to do labor in the field. Because whatever you have, find to do it with all your might. And he went down to the site that day and saw her right there, doing labor there. And called her and said, why are you not in school? Oh, I had to defy because of fees. Oh, okay, go. I'll pay your fees. Why? She found what to do. You see, God knows how to network your breakthrough when you obey the light of scriptures. Is somebody getting what God is saying? He knows how to make it happen. He knows how to make it happen. Just simply engage with what your hands find to do and do it with all your might. With all your might. He knows how to make your breakthrough come to pass. Shout hallelujah. Is somebody getting what God is saying this morning? So, we must recognize that there is a well around you. There is a pot of oil not far from you. Engage with what you have. And as you do, God will meet you with what you desire. Amen. Somebody believe it, say loud amen. The righteous are not permitted to be beggars because they are ordained to eat the fruit of their labor. The fruit of your labor you will eat. Amen. You will never again be a liability to anyone. Amen. Somebody believe it, say loud amen. Therefore, from this moment, favor shall begin to answer for everyone on the line for miracle job. Everywhere you go, favor will start locating you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I said, everywhere you go, favor will start locating you. He said, for thou will arise and bless the righteous with favor. You will surround him like a shield. I see that favor surrounding you from today. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, position yourself appropriately with the expectation for God's visitation. Because today marks a change of story for you. Everyone engaging in kingdom advancement endeavor shall begin to enjoy fearful favor. He said, for thou will arise and have mercy upon Zion, for the time to favor has come. He said, because thy servant take pleasure in the stones of Zion and they favor the very dust thereof. As a result, the heathen shall fear the name of the Lord and all the kings of the earth thy glory. By serving God tirelessly, you position yourself for favor. So favor, supernatural favor, answers to you from today in the name of Jesus Christ. Many of us have been serving God tirelessly, praying kingdom advancement prayer, serving God, going out after souls, serving God in our various service units. For each one of us, I see the favor of God, the fearful favor of God coming upon your life afresh in the name of Jesus. I see that becoming your own testimony in the name of Jesus Christ. However, it must be important that we recognize this. The greatest destroyer of favor is sin, unrighteousness. For thou will surround the righteous with favor. I want you to see this in scriptures, Ecclesiastes chapter 10 and verse 1. If you want to enjoy the favor of God continuously, which is a vital key to breakthrough, maintain a life of sanctity. It said, dead flies cause the ointment of apothecary to send forth a stinking savor. He says, so not a little fool him that has a reputation of wisdom and honor. Dead flies represent dead works. Things that irritate God. He said, it causes the good savor that God has put upon that person's life to begin to smell. The person will begin to have a stinking savor. He has been released favor, but something is corrupting the favor. We must watch out. To maintain favor, maintain sanctity. Maintain sanctity. This life of sanctity positions any man to live a life of continuous favor. I pray that for each one of us, that grace to live a life of sanctity will come afresh upon each one in the name of Jesus. You don't enjoy favor by doctoring your CV and putting things that are not true there. They say, what is your experience? I worked in KPMG. I worked in Accenture. I worked in all of these places. 5 years I was in KPMG, and you only graduated 3 years ago. 2 other years I was in Accenture. The other year I was in this, and you put it all there, including fake referees who you have already informed. When they call you, tell them you are the manager. And when they ask you, this is what you need to tell them. You can't enjoy favor that way. You can't enjoy favor by cutting corners in business. You sell spare parts. You brought one that is, you know, a spare part that is made in the corner somewhere by a few welders that join some parts together and just shine the metal together and put it out there and say, this one is original. This one is original. It has come directly now. I just went to the port to get it. You can't enjoy favor that way. You are a mechanic. You clean the man's old part and sold it to him as a new part. You can't enjoy favor that way. The favor of God comes following righteousness. Following righteousness. So if we want to enjoy divine favor, we must position ourselves appropriately in the light of scriptures. Doing that which God has ordained, thou will bless the righteous, not everyone. For with favor you will surround him as with a shield. We must understand, with God, there is no Nigerian way. There's only the way of God. If we follow his way, we get his will. If you follow your way, you miss his will. Is somebody getting what God is saying? There must be sanctity to keep enjoying the favor of God. I pray for each one of us this morning that the grace for this sanctity to be maintained will come afresh in the name of Jesus Christ. Please hear this. It doesn't matter what righteousness costs you. It will pay you more than it costs you. Joseph was in a job in Potiphar's house. And then Potiphar's wife cast her eyes upon him and began to desire him for an immoral relationship. And one day caught him by the coat and said, now lie with me. He had a decision to make. Do I secure my job or do I stand for righteousness? And the Bible said, if it is my coat you catch, you cannot catch my hand. Took off, left his coat, and the woman held on to it. You thought you have run away, I will show you who is in charge. And that day he was discharged from what seemed like his only way of livelihood, cast into prison. But wherever righteousness takes you, it must lift you from there. He didn't know that woman's agitation was a test. God has arranged an appointment for him in the prison that will take him to the palace. The question I will ask you is that if he secured his job by immorality, will he get to the palace? No way. What you think sin will keep for you is less than what sin will steal from you. And here comes the man, Joseph, one day, sitting upon the throne. And I can see Potiphar sheepishly saluting. Because he's afraid that if he remembers his face, he may punish him. Sheepishly saluting. And the Bible said concerning this same Joseph, that God gave him the capacity to teach the senators wisdom. He was in a place of authority by a life of sanctity. I'd like you to get set, because by that grace that is coming upon your life afresh this morning, you shall be ascending thrones that no one can imagine. And should there be anyone here that righteousness has cost you something, I have good news for you. It will pay you more than it costs you from this day. Somebody believe it, say loud amen. I said somebody believe it, say loud amen. Somebody believe it, say loud amen. Your story has changed. I say your story has changed. Everyone that has come today on the line for miracle job, for promotion, for contract, for breakthroughs on any side, by the encounter you have had this morning, that breakthrough has come your way already. In the name of Jesus Christ. What you have been looking for will begin looking for you. Somebody believe it, say loud amen. Lift your hand to heaven this morning and begin to give God the glory. Appreciate him, glorify him, honor him. He's worthy of praise, he's worthy of glory, he's worthy of honor, he's worthy of all adoration. Father, thank you. Blessed be your name. 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 Lift your voice right now and give him the glory. Lift your voice right now and give him the glory. Father, thank you. Blessed be your holy name. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be glorified. We celebrate you, Jesus. Thank you, mighty God. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. This morning, please take your seat, everyone. This morning, before we go any further in this service, you are here today. You have not surrendered your life to Jesus. You have not yet made him the Lord and the Savior of your life. You have an opportunity right now to align yourself with Christ. Everything turns around when a man is connected to Christ. Today will be your day of a turnaround. Wherever you are this morning, you want to surrender your life to Jesus. You want to make him the Lord and the Savior of your life. Quickly rise on your feet right now. Quickly rise on your feet right now. All over this place, you want to give your life to Jesus. You want to become a child of God. You want to have a genuine connection with your Maker. Quickly rise on your feet right now. All over this place, I want to pray with you. You are going to have a new beginning. Also, listen, there are those who are here who need to reconnect to Jesus. You have been in Christ before, but somewhere along the line, maybe from one situation or another, you found yourself disconnected. You have lost touch and you need a new beginning. I want you to also rise on your feet. You want to rededicate your life to Jesus? Quickly rise on your feet right now. I want to pray with you. At the same time, ushers, please let's quickly begin to distribute the flyer for next Sunday, Supernatural Turnaround Banquet. We are taking 2 copies each to advertise for Jesus. Quickly, everyone rise to your feet. If you have done that, everyone who wants to surrender their life to Jesus, to rededicate their lives to him. And if you have done that, quickly move to the aisle closest to you as we get set to pray this morning. Hallelujah. Praise God. Give Jesus a big hand, everyone. Thank you, Lord. Please suspend filling your form for a moment and lift up your right hand to heaven and pray this prayer after me from the depth of your heart. Say after me, Lord Jesus, louder, Lord Jesus, I come to you today as a sinner. I know you died for me. On the 3rd day, you rose again just to save me. Jesus, come into my life today as my Lord and Savior. Take control of me from this day forward. Now I know that I am born again. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. In Jesus' name, amen. Now I pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you today for each one of these precious ones that have come to you. Your word says that no one that comes to you will you in any wise cast away. Therefore, we know that in accordance with your word, each one here has been received into your family. Therefore, give them grace to walk with you. Grace to walk with you from this day forward. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, mighty God. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Amen and amen. Congratulations. It's a new day for you. Please ensure your form is completed. You submit it to the official and then you return back to your seat. Shall we all rise on our feet this morning? Thank you, Jesus. We are going to pray. And first of all, we are praying in 2 dimensions. We have come here for a banquet. A banquet means pick what you want. There are different things that we have heard this morning from the manifestations of the Spirit of God to our right to jobs, to advancement, to promotion by redemption. You are going to take hold of your own portion right now. Lord, I believe your word. And I cry to you this morning, give me the spirit of wisdom. Give me the spirit of dedication. Give me the spirit of glory. And Lord, this desire I have, the miracle job, the promotion, the advancement, the breakthrough, give it to me. Be specific in your own terms. Lift your voice now and pray passionately. You are before the Lord. It's a banquet. You can pick what you want. And you pick it by speaking. You pick it by speaking. Begin to make declarations. cry unto him this morning as you take delivery of the desire of your heart. As you take delivery of the desire of your heart. As you take delivery of the desire of your heart. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice and pray, 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 pray. From the depth of your heart, let God hear the voice of your supplication. You are taking your portion. You are taking your portion. You are receiving your portion. You are taking it now. You are taking it now. You are taking it now. Pray desperately, for I will pour water upon him that is thirsty and flood upon the dry ground. If you want it, call for it. If you want it, cry for it. If you desire it, cry for it. Let him hear the voice of your supplication. You are crying unto the Lord right now. My Father, give unto me the spirit of wisdom in a new way, the spirit of dedication in a new way, the spirit of glory in a new way. Give it unto me right now. Give it unto me right now. I cry for it now. Oh, my Father, give unto me that which I desire. Call upon the name of the Lord. Be specific. Tell him what you want. You want a miracle job? Tell him what you desire. You want a promotion? Tell him what you want. You want breakthrough in your business? Tell him what you desire. Your market business must increase. There must be increase. There must be breakthrough. There must be advancement. Call upon the name of the Lord. Cry unto him. The manifestation of the Spirit is for your profiting. Call upon him. Tell him what you desire. He's here to give it unto you. He opens his hand and satisfies the desire of every living thing. Cry unto the Lord right now from the depth of your heart. Let him hear the voice of your supplication. Let him hear the voice of your supplication. Let him hear the voice of your supplication. If there is a man to pray, our God is there to answer. Will you cry unto him right now? Cry desperately. He's releasing it now. He's releasing it now. It's coming your way now. It's coming your way now. It's coming your way now. It is coming your way now. It is coming your way now. It is coming your way now. You can call upon the name of the Lord. Do it desperately this morning. There is a turnaround for you. There is a breakthrough for you. There is advancement for you. There is a testimony for you. There is a turnaround. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray. Our God is able to do exceeding abundantly above all you can ask or think. Call upon him now. Cry desperately. Cry desperately. Cry desperately. Our Father is here to deliver the desire of your heart. Cry unto the Lord desperately this morning. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I am asking you this morning that you, oh God, will give a new dimension of the spirit of wisdom, of the spirit of glory, of the spirit of dedication. Let it flow afresh. Let it flow afresh. Let it flow afresh. Let it flow afresh. Oh God, let it flow afresh. Let breakthroughs come afresh. Let open doors come afresh. Lift up your voice. Let God hear you. Lift up your voice. Let God hear you. Lift up your voice. Let God hear you. There is a testimony waiting for you as you call upon the name of the Lord Most High that performing all things for us. Jesus, let there be an outpouring. Jesus, let there be an outpouring. Lift up your voice. Let him hear. You can perfect it in the Holy Ghost now. Rebana koshaba, ilelele ketebra, lembrene ketosusia, elenko panande, riko shabanatalo, imbranango parada, leko shabia, abenom peneketesia, ilavene ketoba, manenko para, manenko para, manenko para, labrania kalado, irabangaka, araganto, imbronekelo, elevene keteri. La copa nekelia imbranoba elebene kelo shadia alebrenia kanatalo leprando rebereria le koshabrania kana imanon geleberia. Oh ye ketelie kanabara. Lift your hands, give him thanks this morning. In the precious name of the Lord Jesus, we have prayed. Lift your hands now in the name of Jesus. For everyone that has desired of the Lord one miracle job, promotion, or breakthrough or the other, receive it now in the name of Jesus. By your encounter today, the yoke of stagnation is broken forever. Anyone that has been at one stage or the other, years have been passing, but change has not been coming. He said, I will restore to you the years that the locusts and the cankerworm, the palmer of my great army have eaten. Whatever has been lost to time is restored to you now. It's restored to you now. It's restored to you now. It's restored to you now. In the name of Jesus. Your long awaited breakthrough is coming your way right now. He didn't call it today a job banquet, but he called it a miracle job. Miracle means not after the natural order. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, by your encounter this morning, protocols will be broken for you. Natural protocol shall be broken on your behalf. It shall be broken on your behalf. It shall be broken on your behalf. It shall be broken on your behalf. In the name of Jesus. Every place of your previous rejection, where you have been told, go away, don't come back again, for you, you shall be called back in honor. And I pray for you this morning, every mockery of your life shall be exchanged for glory today. He said, for your shame, you shall have double. Every place where you have suffered shame, double honor becomes your portion. He said that my people shall never be ashamed. You will never see shame again. I said you will never see shame again. And this very day, the 22nd of October, the Lord has rolled away every reproach, every reproach, every reproach in the name of Jesus Christ. Every reproach is rolled away. Every cause of stagnation, every siege of motionless, every reproach is rolled away in the name of Jesus. Welcome to your new realm of breakthroughs. Somebody believe it, say loud amen. I said, welcome to your new realm of breakthroughs. Welcome to your new realm of breakthroughs. In the name of Jesus Christ. Things are going to begin to happen for you in quick succession. Quick succession. Places you have applied for a long time ago, they will call you swiftly. In the name of Jesus Christ. I said they will call you swiftly. Somebody applied to a place 4 years prior, and they called him 4 years later after an encounter like this. You have had this encounter, even applications you have forgotten, they will start answering for you speedily. Some of you suppliers, contractors, you have been making calls. People that have forgotten about you, refuse to pick your call. They have even deleted your number. They will call you this week. In the name of Jesus Christ. Everything is turning around for you in the name of Jesus. It is done. In Jesus' precious name. Somebody believe, say loud amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Now this morning, we are going to do something very special. Yesterday, the 21st of October, was the 15th anniversary of the founding of Covenant University. Now, hallelujah. Let it be clear that what is happening in Covenant University is not because of human intelligence. Everything that we see today is the product of the hand of God.
It is impossible to explain how a university that is 15 will start competing with a university that 1,000 in age. How can a university that started 15 years ago be the number one university in the country today? This can only be God. And for it, we owe him all the glory. Therefore, this morning, we are going to lift our voice as a congregation, as a family. Because to ignore the doing of God is dangerous. We are saying, Lord, not unto us, not unto us, but unto your name be the glory. Will you stretch your hand towards heaven this morning? And from the depth of your heart, begin to give God thanks for Covenant University. 15 years of unbroken manifestation of the hand of God. Father, not unto us, not unto us, but unto your name be the glory and the praise. Be the glory and the praise. Lift your voice and give thanks from the depth of your heart. Thank him for the supplies he has given to Covenant University. Thank him for the prominence he has given to the university. Thank him for the advancement, for the development. Oh, Father, we give you thanks. You have made this university a beacon of light to a generation in darkness. Our Father, we have come today to say that we are grateful. We have come today to say that we are thankful. We have come today to celebrate your faithfulness. Our Father, we give you thanks. Our Father, we give you glory. Our Father, we give you honor. Will you lift your hand to heaven and from the depth of your heart, give God the glory for what he has done in Covenant University. Oh, Father, 15 years, your hand has been at work. Not one day off. We have seen your mighty hand. We have seen your mighty hand. Not one crisis to manage. Oh, Father, we give you praise. We give you glory. You have been the supply. You have been the glory and the lifter up of our hand. And we have come to say thank you. Not unto us, oh God. Not unto us. Be the glory and be the praise. Lift up your voice and give God the glory. Lift up your voice and give God the glory. Lift up your voice and give God the glory. There is not one day that his hand has been missing in operation. He has been at work at Covenant University. Oh, our Father, we give you thanks. Our Father, we give you glory. Our Father, we give you honor. We celebrate your faithfulness. Not unto us, O Lord, not unto us, but unto thy name be the glory and the praise. Be the glory and the praise. Be the glory and the praise. Not unto us, Father, but unto your name, but unto your name, but unto your name be the glory, be the praise, be the glory, and be the praise. Our Father, we give you thanks. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' precious name. Keep your hand lifted, Father, as one congregation and one family. We have come this morning to say, not unto us, O God, not unto us, but unto thy name be the glory and the praise. Thank you for the supplies that you have given. Thank you for the wisdom that you have given. Thank you for the direction you have given. Thank you for precision that we have enjoyed. Thank you for the advancement we have seen. Thank you for the development around the Covenant University. Thank you for making it an attraction to many. We have never struggled for students. We have never struggled for supplies. We have never struggled with any infrastructural development. All of these are your doings and they are marvelous in our eyes. Every little thing that has come out of that university, you have announced it to the world. You have made it a university of global repute. And for it this morning, we have come to say, Father, we are grateful. Accept our thanksgiving in the name of the Lord Jesus. You have kept it this long and we hand it again to you. We know you will keep it forever. Thank you because we know it's done. In Jesus' precious name. Somebody believe, say loud amen. That same kind of color that God has given the university, we give it to you as well. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, so shall it be. In Jesus' precious name. Somebody believe it, say loud amen. It is done. In Jesus' precious name. Remember, we have been given two flyers. Each one of them represents a soul that we are reaching out to. And everyone that we reach out to with these flyers, none will reject it. And everyone that accepts it will be drawn into God's presence. Will you pick up your copies of those flyers, lift it to the Lord right now? We ask, Lord, make it a sharp sickle in your hand. Make it a sharp sickle in your hand. Make it a sharp sickle in your hand. At least one soul will follow me through these flyers into your presence this coming Sunday in the name of Jesus Christ. Make it a sharp sickle in your hand. Thank you, mighty God. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. So shall it be in Jesus' precious name. Somebody believe it, say loud amen.
Amen.
It is done in Jesus' precious name. Shall we share the goodness of the Lord together? Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever. Amen. Peace. My case is different. Because I'm redeemed of the Lord as a covenant child, what affects others is not permitted to affect me. Congratulations. Congratulate somebody as you go. Be blessed in the name of Jesus.